Hi, I'm Dirk und dieses Video ist auch auf Deutsch verfügbar. Some time ago, I published a video about the assembly of my Prusa MK4 3D printer, together with my colleague Kevin. But in that video, we only got halfway finished, so here is now the second part, finally revealing whether we were successful. Before I start, some words about how this video was made, because filming a video lots of hours seemed a bit overkill to me, so I used the time-lapse function of my Canon EOS 80D, every 30 seconds a photo without time limit. I set the camera to manual focus to prevent focus pumping and used automatic aperture and shutter speed, classic P mode. And one thing I changed compared to the first day, I got an additional headlight, and this makes the pictures much brighter and better. This is how the setup looked like. But enough of the introduction. Here is how Kevin and I continued our Prusa MK4 3D printer build. And so we started the second day, and as you see here, compared to the first day, the light actually is really better. First thing is, of course, to put the printers back onto the table and to put all the devices, the material and the tools back into operation. And then we start with the next step, and the next step actually is the display of the printer, which is put in front of the printer. And it has to be assembled too, of course, by this electronics board here and this cover, and then we screw it all together so that the display is behind its cover. And then of course we need cables, and you can see these cables here, and this is one is the data cable, which has to be put into the electronics box, and then we have here this earthing cable, which is also needed actually for the complete printer. And we start by applying both of them onto the display, as you can see here, and then we can mount the display on the printer, as we do here. And then we start putting the cables into the printer, and for this, as you can see here, we are using the cable clamps that we have put onto the printer frame at the very beginning of this whole construction. So you see that this now becomes important. Okay, and once we have started with all these cables and the wiring, we can simply go on with it and attach several further cables which are still missing so far. And the important ones are, of course, the power cables for the main electronics, which have to be attached to the power supply, as you can see here, and then put through the frame towards the main electronics box. And you see these cables are rather thick, and this of course is because such a printer needs quite an amount of energy when it works. Especially heating things always needs lots of energy. Okay, and then we take all these cables and put them onto the frame and attach them to the printer frame and lead them towards the main electronics box. You see this becomes quite crowded, the bottom of the printer with all these cables, and you have to be careful to do this as exactly as possible compared to the manual, because otherwise cables can become too short. And you can see here that I actually made a mistake at this step, because I put the data cable at the one side of these cables here and the earthing cable on the other side, and that resulted in a problem with putting, I think, the earthing cable at the places where it needed to be put, and then I had to undo some of the zip ties so that I could correct this step. Fortunately, this is no problem, because there are more than enough zip ties into this printer kit. And you see here how all these cables come into this electronic box and have to be attached here. And this can become quite crowded there too, and therefore you have to be precise with how you do the cables. And once all the cables are there, you also have to attach the zip ties, which have been prepared there, so that all these cables are well organized. And if you do this, and if you do this correctly, once you have finished this step, you see that all the cables are on one side of this electronics box, and things seem to be quite tidy and clean in there. And this is how it should look like when you do things correctly. Okay, having applied all these cables, now leads us to the next step, and that is to take the printer aside for a moment and continue with the heat plate. You can see here the heat plate with the thermal probe already installed here, and these magnets which will hold the print plate once everything comes together. But first step is to prepare the heat plate, and preparing means to do the wiring, and the wiring especially means to put the power supply cables on this. These cables are also quite thick. Once again, it's about heating, and heating needs much of energy. And then you take the wire and the cover, as we have done this in the earlier steps, to prevent the cables from jamming anything, and we put the wire on it, and then we put the cover around them, and then we fix this with screws and with zip ties, so that this part is also finished now. And now comes the next mechanical part, and that's the base plate for the heat plate. And that one is the one which is moved backward and forward. And when you move things backward and forward, what do you need? Right, you need some more bearings. You can see the bearings here. You have to degrease them on the outside. You have to grease them on the inside. And then you have the bearings prepared. And then you have to mount the bearings on the base plate, as you can see here. And when you have mounted the bearings on the base plate, the next thing you need are the rods on which the bearings will run. And then you put the bearings onto the rods. And once you have done that, you prepare the rods to be installed into the frame of the printer. And this is done here. And when you have prepared it, you can install all this in the printer. And then you have the base plate, which can be moved forward and backward. Having a base plate being able to be moved forward and backward is nice, but now you need some means to actually articulate it. And for this, we already have installed the motor. You can see it here. This was also at the very beginning of this whole construction work. But there are some parts still missing, and the missing parts are, of course, the gear belt. You can see it here. And the pulley, you can see it here, I think, which leads the gear belt around so that the motor can move the base plate in both directions. And now we have to install all this. Here's the gear belt mount, which you then put below the base plate, and then you take the gear belt and put it around the motor, and then you attach the second mount so that it can be put onto the base plate again. And then you need the pulley, and then you mount the pulley into the pulley holder, and then you have mounted the complete gear belt. And having this gear belt now means that to ensure that it operates correctly, you have to measure its tension, and you do this as you did with the other gear belt in this device by taking the Prusa website and measure the frequency of the gear belt when you touch it with the mobile. And when the frequency is within a certain range, then the gear belt is also installed correctly. Okay. And now things really start to come to an end, because after you have installed the base plate in the printer, now you can put the heat plate onto the base plate. But there is only a tiny problem, because this heat plate, the name says it, becomes hotter and colder, and things which become hotter and colder tend to enlarge or shrink. And therefore you can't just screw it onto this base plate, because then you would get too much tension in this whole thing. And therefore the heat plate actually is only fixed at one position, at the middle of the base plate, and at all the other sides and edges of the base plate you have these cramps, which allow to ease the tension between the base plate and the heat plate. And once you have mounted that, once you have installed that, you can actually mount the heat plate on the base plate and fix it with all the screws. And once you have done that, you can finally attach the cables of the heat plate to the main electronics, so that the heat plate, that the thermal probe and the heating actually can be controlled by the main electronics. And then you are almost finished with the electronics. The one missing thing now is the Wi-Fi module. And this Wi-Fi module, you can see it here, is after all only a small ESP32 module, which is mounted outside the main electronics, because due to the Wi-Fi signal, of course, it can't be mounted within this metal case, but you have this connector here. And what you are actually doing is just put the Wi-Fi module onto this connector and then put the plate, the cover, onto the Wi-Fi module, and you are actually done with it. And you're not only done with the Wi-Fi module, but now you are done with the electronics after all completely, and you can cover the completely electronics here with the metal cover for this thing. And then you are also done with this one. The printer now becomes more and more finished, and one of the final things that is now missing is the filament holder, which is put on top of the printer. And unfortunately, this can't be seen that good in this video because of the camera angle, but we are now installing the filament holder on top. And having done that, we only need to do two further things. One thing is to clean the heat plate here with this isopropanol, and then we can put the print plate onto the heat plate. And having done this, the printer actually is ready. And now we come to the crucial question: will it really print? 1, 2, 3. Hier fühlen Sie durch den Einrichtungsprozess.
Hot End Lüfter Drehzahltest.
Der Drehzahltest ist fehlgeschlagen.
Meiner nicht. Zu fest.
Okay.
Sie haben zu früh gekippt. Sie haben zu früh getippt. Sie haben zu früh getippt. Tippen Sie auf die Düse beim Piepen.
Jetzt. Heizungsprüfung hat geklappt. 1,5 Umdrehungen gegen den Uhrzeigersinn, der ist zu groß.
Also los.
Ja, 1,5 Umdrehungen, bis sie bündig sind. Ja, das passt. Bitte warten Sie 20 Sekunden. Ziehen Sie die Schrauben in der folgenden Reihenfolge an. Sie sollten etwas unterhalb der Oberfläche liegen. Verwenden Sie nicht zu viel Kraft. Kein Filament im Extruder. Befindet sich ein Filament im Filamentsensor?
Nein. Führen Sie Filament ein. Rein, Ende. Erkannt.
Der Selbsttest wurde nicht beendet. Überprüfen Sie die Verkabelung und die Achsen des Druckers. Okay.
Was war dein Fehler?
Der Hot-End-Lüfter. Wo ist das?
Hauptmenü, Steuerung, Selbsttest starten.
Aber der läuft, oder nicht?
Ja.
Die laufen beide.
Ja, ich würde sagen, lass den mal einfach mal durchlaufen.
Ja, Hot-End-Lüfter-Drehzahltest schlägt fehl.
Was kann denn das sein?
Gut, also das hat dann so mittelgut geklappt und jetzt schauen wir mal, woran es liegt. So, fürs Protokoll, beim nächsten Selbsttest hat die Lüfterregelung jetzt funktioniert und insofern kann es jetzt losgehen.
Die Prusa-Schrift kommt nach vorne. Der ist erstmal sehr stramm.
So, da sind wir.
Da steht jetzt USB.
Drucken. Keychain Dual Color.
Genau.
10 Minuten, 4 Sekunden.
Ich oben durch.
Das ist jetzt sehr aufregend.
Ein liebes Filament.
PLA. So. Das ist jetzt, wie gesagt, alles sehr aufregend. 17%.
20, 23, 28. Ist das aufregend? Ja, Filament lädt. Ja, da passiert was. Das Heizbett unten wird aufgeladen. Da unten kann man das sehen. So, und 60. Was passiert jetzt? Da läuft Filament raus.
Dann macht man das ab.
Oh.
Tippt das wirklich an? Siehst du diese Nozzle hier?
Einfach rausnehmen, kann ich das jetzt schon?
Ja, der hat schon entladen. Und was dabei?
Oh, da kommt was daneben.
Dann abziehen.
Ja, mein erster Filamentabfall.
Genau.
Oh, da ist noch Filament dran.
Mir auch.
So, time for conclusion. It is printing. And in hindsight, it has not been that difficult. A 3D printer might look complicated, but on the level we are working here, it is a rather simple device. Move the extruder along the axis, and for this you need motors, gear bells, pulleys, geared rods, and bearings on rods. Okay, and the electronic stuff. And the wiring, and this delicate extruder thingy here. Well, okay, it's not that simple, but totally doable even if you are not a precision engineering pro. Now, if you want also to assemble your MK4 printer from a kit, pro tip, read the manual. It sounds simple, but there are stories in the internet like, well, it did not fit, so I pressed harder, and then it broke. Do. We always performed each step only after we really understood what we were doing. If in doubt, read again. And doing it together also helps, as there is always one to ask a question or explain again. And building together simply is more fun. The manual lists for each step exactly which amount of which parts you need. Only take those ones out of the bags and leave everything else where it is. Put the bags back into their boxes so that you can find them quickly again, and recollect all the tools after each step and put them back onto their place. Otherwise, these things start to live on their own. The included tools work well, but an additional sorting box, magnetic plate, some tweezers, and another wire cutting pliers make things easier. And take your time. The instructions say assembly of the MK4 needs about 8 hours. Well, in the beginning we thought we are so good we only will need 6. We ended up needing 14 hours and I never had the feeling that I had nothing to do. Haste makes waste. At the end, our printers were ready and successfully produced their first test prints. So we took them to our respective homes, and how things then continued for me and my Prusa MK4, that's the story of another video, at least. So see you next time and thanks for watching.
Ich habe nicht aufgezeichnet. Wieso habe ich nicht aufgezeichnet? Verf